What is up, YouTube? It is Onion Bomb here. Welcome back to another episode of South Park. Today we're on episode 12 of season 2. This one is just simply called Clubhouses. A little bit of a difference from the last episode that was titled Roger Ebert Should Lay Off the Fatty Foods. And that really didn't have anything to do with anything. It was about the planetarium guy brainwashing the people who go into the planetarium to work at the planetarium because the planetarium was failing. A little bit of a planetarium slander last episode. I'll take that other than Kenny slander, but he had a gruesome death last time. But last one was pretty funny. We'll see what this one is about. Clubhouses is gonna have to do with clubhouses, probably, maybe not. I don't know. You know how South Park goes. Before we jump into this, though, I want to show you guys something real quick. Oh, South Park!
This is an interesting looking anime.
This place is ugly as hell.
Oh my goodness, it's actually them.
Who the hell are you?
Excuse me, we're looking for our way home.
Wow, didn't know you were planning on bringing your mom to school today, Kat. Shut up, Cartman!
Hey, only I get to bully this green turd.
Dude, your towel talks!
The hell did you just say, you little fat ass?
Hey, don't call me fat, you dumbass towel!
You're a towel.
Come oh no. Be careful, Kenny. Oh no.
God damn it.
I'm sorry about him.
Likewise. Let's go.
Come on.
Okay, screw this. These 2D swords can't do shit. I'm going back to 3D.
Bob, what are you doing?
Wow, and I thought you were ugly before.
Shut up, you stupid b***h! Hi-ya!
Jesus Christ! Kenny, you gotta help me, man!
Oh no! Oh no!
Oh my God, they killed Kenny!
No! They killed Kenny! No! Not even an SMG4 can he survive!
Team Sherry got over by. We're starting in 3. Two.
No. Now, can you guys handle this animation?
One.
Alright, bro. So a little bit ago on stream, I watched this YouTube series called SMG4. And if you don't know what it is, it's just like... I'm trying to think, how do I explain it? It's like a Gmod, like, skit series, almost. They had like a South Park bit, and not even in SMG4 can Kenny survive. Kenny dies. I wanted to just share that real quick because I was just like, unbelievable, man. It's just not fair. Poor Kenny, forever and always, poor Kenny. Recording this one in the morning, a little change of pace, so if you see, like, the sun rays coming, I'm sorry.
Sergeant Stanley Marsh is trapped behind enemy lines. His only chance of survival is to sneak past the Bosnian guard who stands watch. Majesty's heart! It will take more than your weak American weapons to destroy me.
Cartman, we shot your Bosnian fat ass.
Yeah, you're dead. I have class 4 armor on.
Class 4.
No, you don't. Special armor.
This is Bluey levels of acting.
If you want to play Americans versus Bosnians anymore, you can just play with yourself. That's fine. I like playing with myself. I play with myself all day long.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just a Cartman.
Hiya, doesn't Bebe look pretty today?
I don't know.
She does, she looks very pretty.
Okay.
Stan, can I talk to you for a second?
Oh. Does she like Kyle?
Wouldn't it be fun if we fixed Kyle up with Bebe?
No.
If Bebe and Kyle are a couple, then we can invite them over to your clubhouse for dinner and play parlor games and have meaningful conversations and sip cognac by the fireplace.
We could?
Yes, Stan.
But dude, I don't have a clubhouse.
You don't? I thought all guys had clubhouses.
Just how many guys' clubhouses have you been in?
Comment on comment has ways of making you talk.
Mom, you have to build a clubhouse. No, Kenny.
You do? We're going to build a clubhouse. I have to ask my dad for help.
Did it work? I think it did, baby. If all goes as planned, Kyle will be your new boyfriend.
I hope so, Wendy. He's got such a hot ass.
Aren't they like 8? Whatever happened to cooties? Everyone likes Terrence and Philip in this universe.
Whoa, dude, your dad is watching Terrence and Philip.
No, I was just flipping through the channels.
Hey, Dad, we need to build a clubhouse.
Okay.
How do we do it?
You just get a hammer and some wood. What, does some girls want to play truth or dare or something?
Yeah, dude, how'd you know?
How do you think I met your mother?
Randy, my wedding ring. I lost it down the garbage disposal.
Oh, brother.
Thought I told you not to watch this horrible cartoon.
Yeah, Stanley, you should know better.
Dude!
You watch nice cartoons like Fat Abbott.
You need to lose weight.
I lose weight when I feel like it, bitch. Shut your bitch-ass mouth, huh?
Bitch, I'll kick your ass.
Whoa, dude, sweet.
You think you
this is better than Terrence and Phillip?
Don't snap at me.
I didn't snap at you.
You snapped at me.
Whatever.
Whatever? In 15 years, you've never said whatever to me.
I don't want to fight. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Well, I think I found it.
That's not it, you idiot.
Hey, back off, bitch.
You just said the C word.
What? Did I?
When we're finished, Wendy and Bebe can come over and play.
Dude, what kind of sick joke is that? Girls suck ass.
Well, of course they do, but wouldn't it be sweet to play truth or dare with them?
What? Why?
Because, dude, we could make them do really gross stuff like eat bugs.
Hey, yeah, that'd be sweet. We could totally ruin their lives.
Clubhouse? That's the lamest thing I've ever heard.
It's not lame, it's sweet. After we build this clubhouse, we're gonna get girls to play truth or dare.
Why?
Because, dumbass, we can dare them to do gross stuff and make them cry.
What, were you born yesterday?
Yeah, now beat it, you guys. This clubhouse is private.
Thanks, Dan. We'll build our own clubhouse. Fine.
Oh.
Fine, and then we'll get girls to play truth or dare, too.
The
fine.
Cartman and Kenny clubhouse?
No, Kenny, you can't. Look, I'm the foreman. Because, Kenny, your family's poor. You have to be the worker. No, Kenny!
How's the treehouse coming along, huh?
It's not a treehouse, it's a clubhouse. You pull up the carpeting in the living room.
Well, I don't know, Eric. If you did that, then the floors would be bare.
But me, huh? The carpet says we need carpeting in the clubhouse.
Well, all right.
Kenny, my mom says you can go get carpeting in the living room now. And stop your bitches.
I know the majority of the episode is probably going to be Stan and Kyle, and there's going to be, you know, there's a whole other thing, because Kyle doesn't even know that Bebe likes her, that Stan's using him to get, like, the Wendy thing, and he's going to use the truth or dare to make them do gross things, but Stan wants it, you know, for other reasons, but man, I want to see Cartman and Kenny, I want to see this duo. That's literally I like Stan and Kyle too. This is a good group, but Cartman and Kenny, literally my two favorite characters.
Focus on American.
When is
history,
Mr. Hat coming
right, Mr. Twig?
Back?
That's right, Mr. Garrison. American history.
When is Mr. Hat coming back?
That's yeah.
What did you say?
When is Mr. Hat coming back?
I told you never to mention that name in my classroom again. Mr. Hat is a two-timing whore, and now we all learn from Mr. Twig.
But Mr. Twig sucks.
Yeah!
That is enough. Mr. Head is gone, and he isn't coming back, and I don't want to hear it. Anyway, children, let's
bring
turn
back
our history
Mr.
textbooks to page 105.
What is Mr. Head? We don't want to learn from Mr. Twig.
Don't forget, you need to cut school early and wait for the hot tub guy.
Almost.
Oh, you know
Stan, are you paying attention?
Yes, Mr. Garrison.
Pass this up. Pass this up.
Pass this up.
Stanley, are you passing notes to Kyle?
No, I just...
Don't lie, Stan. Lying makes you sterile.
I'm not lying. Someone just handed me the...
Stanley, if you think it's so important to keep interrupting my class, then why don't you come up to the front and read your notes to Kyle for everyone to hear?
I didn't write the note,
Mr. Garrison. This behavior is having an adverse effect on my education.
Shut up, Cartman.
Stanley Marsh, you come up here right now and read your note.
Oh, no. This isn't his note.
Dear Kyle, you have got such a great ass. I could sleep for days on those perk cheeks, let me tell you. I'd like to live with you and wear your ass as a hat for all eternity. Whoa, dude.
Oh, man.
Now, young man. You know, like tomfoolery.
Cool. Randy, let me handle this. Now, Stanley, I want you to explain to me why you were passing notes in school.
It wasn't my note, dude. It was some girl's.
Okay, Stanley, we're all here to get to the root of your behavior disorder.
You really should know better, Stanley.
You need to shape up, mister.
Don't interrupt me. You always interrupt me when I talk. Can't you see that
I don't interrupt you.
Goodness. There, you did it again.
You should let your wife finish talking, Mr. Marsh. Now, Stan, I want
okay,
you to...
Okay, I'm sorry I interrupt, but she always takes over any conversation.
Taking over any conversation's bad.
Like you're one to talk. When's the last time you really listened to what I had to say?
Please, man.
Interesting to say.
It's about to be a marriage counselor.
Apparently we have a bit of a communication problem here.
Is.
No, she is.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I'm wrong again.
Okay.
And we built it with our own hands. Now we need it. Kenny.
Whoa.
All right, you go find chicks, Kenny.
Where was it going to go find chicks?
Where do I?
Single roof. Testify, Kenny.
Where was it going to go find chicks?
Well, I think I had to say, why do I have to be the one that to go find chicks?
And work. I still got a single roof, test the foundation, run all kinds of inspections. I've got way too much to do, and all you have to do is go find chicks. Now stop your bitching.
Oh, no.
Man, can I watch American Dad?
That's crazy.
Dude, where have you been? I've been waiting all afternoon.
I got in trouble for that note baby was trying to pass to you.
To me?
I mean, no, not to you. Forget it. Come on, dude, we have to finish our clubhouse quick. The girls want to play Truth or Dare tomorrow.
We should use nails, dude. My mom won't let us.
How are you going to build it?
Well, hurry. We want to play Truth or Dare.
We're going as fast as we can.
Kyle, could you turn around for a second? Thank you.
Hey, Stan, do you know how to play Truth or Dare?
No.
Well, dude, how the hell are we supposed to play it then?
I didn't even think about that.
And then they'll ask Truth or Dare.
And I say Dare.
No, no. You say Truth.
Truth? But that's boring. I want to get Dared to kiss her.
You have to say Truth the first few times, or else you seem too eager.
Oh.
Come in the ship with this.
Dare.
Oh.
And then her little friend will dare you to kiss Wendy.
You really think so?
Of course you will. They're women. They've had this whole thing planned out months ahead of time.
Wow. Oh, hey, Kenny, did you find any chicks to come to the clubhouse?
Mm-hmm. Hi, we ran away from home. Oh. Like, this kid told us we might be able to crash at your clubhouse for a couple days.
Behold, Ewok Village 2000.
You calorate, Kenny.
I guess he's living at home.
Can I offer you ladies a cool beverage or a tasty snack? I tell you that me and Kenny have finished our clubhouse and we already have chicks over.
No, you don't.
Dude, it's only a matter of time before we're playing Truth or Dare with him. Good luck with your piece of crap clubhouse. Bad Uncle Brad.
Mommy, please ask Dad to come help me build my clubhouse.
Stanley, I think you should know that your father has moved out.
What?
What?
Why? Because we're divorced, Stanley.
Divorced? Oh, no. Oh, my fault, isn't it?
Yeah, kind of.
Dude, you're not supposed to say that.
But I would like you to meet your new stepfather, Roy.
Hello, son.
What?
I'll leave you two alone to get acquainted.
Hello, Stanley.
How long was the time from the guidance counselor meeting to now? What?
You're gonna cut me some slack, huh? I have taken you under my wing and done my best, and all you ever do is whine and moan about it. Now, for the last time, go cut some firewood.
Stanley, it's time to go.
Go where?
Your bastard father has visitation rights, and this is his time with you.
But no, I have to go get the girls to come.
Come on, Stanley.
Weak!
Hop in. Listen, Stanley, I know all this change must be tough on you, but you know, your mother and I thought it'd be best for all of us if we split up.
But I don't understand why we have to...
Well, hello, ladies.
Hi, handsome. We're gonna be at Larry's bar tonight.
I'm already there. What were we talking about? Oh, yeah. See, your mother and I still care about you and your sister. We just don't like being around each other anymore.
Well, I don't like being around my sister anymore. Does that mean I can leave her too?
Well, no, because you're family. You can't just leave family. You have to stick with family no matter what.
But you and mom are family. How come you can just split up? You know what I think?
I think that when you and Mom got married, you became family. And now that you are, you shouldn't be able to leave her any more than I can leave my sister.
Oh, Stan, you're so young. You just don't get it. See it in. Go on, get out. You know that nothing is more important to me than you, right, Stan?
I guess, but... Truth the first couple of times, okay?
Who wants to go first?
I will.
Kyle?
Yeah?
Truth or dare?
Dare?
Dude, what?
Kiss baby on the lips.
What? Sick, dude, I'm not kissing a girl.
What's the matter, Kyle?
It's just wrong, that's all. Don't be a chicken, dude. Just close your eyes. What the hell have you gotten me into?
You're probably in his clubhouse playing truth or dare with girls right now. You really want him to beat us?
Oh, boy. Sick!
Wow, look at that ass! Shake it, baby!
Your turn, baby!
Okay, Stan. Truth or dare? Stan, truth or dare?
Dare.
Son, could you please come help me with the firewood?
Oh, no.
Dude, we cut firewood all day yesterday. We have enough to last 12 years.
When will you let me in? Let me love you! Now get your ass out here and help me.
Always gives me shit for smoking, but it's my body. I should be able to do whatever I want with it.
Teddy. My mom gives me shit sometimes, and I tell her to shut her hole before I kick her in the night.
Eric, Pookums, it's time for Mommy to tuck you into your snuggle bowl for night-night. Eric, are you out there in your clubhouse?
Okay, we have to play truth or dare quick.
Hey, girls.
What's up?
Oh, hey, Scott.
Who the hell are you?
Oh, we invited some people over. Hope you don't mind.
How many people?
Kyle, can I talk to you?
Okay.
Kyle, this is very difficult for me. I think we need time apart.
Huh?
I'm just feeling really trapped. I can't go on with this codependency.
What?
Okay, that's fine.
No, no. Don't speak. Just try and understand.
Am I missing? Is this episode missing some stuff? Like, we keep going from point A to point C with some of these.
I don't care.
Please, just remember the good times we had. I'll never forget you. Never.
Okay, Clyde, we can go now.
Bitched.
Clyde.
These are not your dad. You can't just go around playing games with my emotions.
Stanley, what did you do to Roy?
Roy's a dick. He ruined my chances with Wendy in the clubhouse.
Stanley, you know you're the most important thing to me, right?
That's true. Then get back together with Dad for me.
Now, Stanley, you have to understand how divorce works. When I say you're the most important thing to me, what I mean is you're the most important thing after me and my happiness and my new romances.
Oh. My stepdad popped me in my eye.
Stepdad? You got off his ass.
Really?
Yeah, bitch. Snatch his ass in a bear trap. Leave that swinging from a tree so high, nobody finds him for days.
Oh my goodness, they made a whole party.
Hey, kid, give me some of those.
Hey, when are we gonna play truth or dare?
What? That game's for kids.
This is ball crap.
Oh boy, it's getting late. I'm gonna have to leave this party.
Stay.
I wish we'd never built a clubhouse.
Mosh pit!
Hmm? No. No!
Oh my god! They killed Kenny! You bastard!
Yo! Cartman said this stuff! And Kyle was walking to you! I thought the whole thing was gonna come down on top of him, to be honest, but he just gets stomped on. I thought, like, maybe he'd come out of that, but I saw the blood, and I know.
Dan, meet me in the clubhouse.
Sharon, have you seen my copy of Harper's?
Meet me at the clubhouse.
Oh, no.
Oh, Randy, what are you doing here?
I got a note from Stanley to come out to the clubhouse.
Oh, I thought that note was for me.
Oh, maybe it was.
Right.
Sharon?
Yes?
Truth or dare?
It's too late for games.
No, I'm serious. Please, truth or dare?
Truth.
Do you still love me?
Oh, Randy, I do love you, but now I'm so confused. I'm living with Roy, and I don't know how to break it off with him.
Sharon?
Well, you never know. Maybe things will work out.
Hello?
Maybe. I guess it's my turn. Truth or dare?
Sharon?
Dare.
Do me. Right dare. Here in the clubhouse.
Hello? Hello? Tell me, hello?
Wow, clubhouses are magical. Dare.
Take this stick and jam it up your pee hole.
What?
Hello?
He's still hanging there?
Anybody? This certainly does suck right here. Hello?
All that first poor Stan, though. I mean, he was probably just gonna throw up afterwards anyhow. That episode was pretty funny. I especially liked Cartman and Kenny moments. Stan's parents went through a whole divorce. I think they're back together now. I don't know where I think, did they both accidentally get the letter and it was meant for Roy and they just like missed the rope and he tripped it? Cause I was worried that he was gonna spring a trap on his mom, but then they made it to the clubhouse. Cartman now has this big clubhouse in his backyard, and it hosts a party. he hosts a party unwillingly. 2 minutes, by the way. There's 2 minutes left in the episode. When Kenny died. One of these days, South Park, I know it's a promise. You can just let it go. You can just let it go. I know you did for the Christmas episode. I know. But you can do it again. It doesn't have to be Christmas for Kenny to survive. Cartman saying, oh my god, they killed Kenny was interesting. Because other than the one time, it was like, oh my god, I found a penny. I think it's always been Stan and Kyle. But Cartman filled in today. Props to them for actually building clubhouses. Like, at 8 years old? I could not build a clubhouse at 8. Oh, them mentioning, when is Mr. Hat coming back? That was hilarious. It was like the perfect timing too, because I just asked the same thing. And at least they're acknowledging that, you know, he is coming back. Or they're not acknowledging that he's gone, so he might come back. I don't know. It's been a while. It's definitely longer than I thought. But Mr. Garrison doesn't seem the happiest with Mr. Hat. I wonder if that's going to be an episode. At some point, like, it's gonna be about him and Mr. Hat getting back together. I feel like it's gotta be now. Maybe they're saving that for the finale, because, they gotta one-up, discovering who Cartman's mom is from last season. Yeah, a lot of funny moments in this episode. Hopefully Stan's parents stay together and don't get divorced. It was a close call, but, you know, they went through it. Yeah, Kyle almost, had someone that liked him, but, she seemed, to move on pretty quickly. All in all, another good episode, a really funny one. I enjoyed it a lot. It was about clubhouses. Like, that was the episode. Sometimes the episode title is very simple, and it's like, oh, okay. Other times, it's, you know, it's a little bit different, but this was one of the more simple ones. Just clubhouses. And, yeah, there was indeed clubhouses. I need more of Kenny and Cartman just, like, I don't know, just doing antics. They're doing something, being a duo, because that was great. That was great, him just, like, and, like, Kenny complaining in his muffled hoodie, like, and Cartman just be like, hey! just barking orders. That was funny. And, you know, you always just like seeing your two favorite characters in any show just, like, interact. We'll see if, you know, that's ever a thing again. And it was funny how they were, like, in competition with each other, with Kyle and Stan. Really like the characters in this, like Mr. Mackey, he's hilarious, like, oh, so many good characters in this, like, so many funny people, it's great. Really, really enjoying South Park, I'm really, like, watching it, and really get excited for future episodes and the next episode, and it's some good laughs, it's some good humor. I don't know, like I said, I can't Can't wait for the next one. For now, though, guys, that is going to do it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like or dislike, subscribe or don't subscribe. You know it's always up to you. I will see you guys in the next video. You watch it for me. Goodbye.